What is up, everybody? Welcome back to the Eclectic Beard. So this go around, we got Devlin Popular Fashion. And this is a pseudo music video, so I'm guessing this is just placeholder till it actually comes out with the video. Love Devlin's music, everything I've heard so far. This being 7 days old now, behind the, whenever you stop taking and doing so many music reactions, you kind of miss out sometimes. You don't take and hit the you don't hit the reactions as like as soon as the song comes out, so you kind of left scrambling a little bit sometimes if you don't get right on it. So yeah, but let's go ahead and look at this one anyways.
I spit drugs and there's more, son. You could have made a cut if you got bored up by a door. I'm so big that it's probably more of a sword, bruv. Saw luck, tell him that the roof up, warmed up. I ain't even sweat yet. I might send for myself in my deathbed.
The audio is kind of low on this. We'll take this back just a little bit. Not only that, what is the smooth but yet very quick delivery? Rewind us.
I spit drugs and there's more, son. You could have made a cut if you got bored up by a door. I'm so big that it's probably more of a sword, bruv. Saw luck, tell him that the roof up, warmed up. I ain't even sweat yet. I might send for myself in my deathbed. There's only one MC here that could run up on a record then end my career. Charismatic, shoot drugs from the larynx, a grime addict. I'm headlights, your rabbits. Tell him it's a rap when I'm rapping, no slacking. I'm sending you campus packing for a.
So he's definitely going in real hard with the symbolism in the very first bit of very first bit of the first verse. A lot of metaphorical stuff talking about how basically he's the best in the game. Ain't nobody but one person in the game to take come at him, and like he his shit's lethal.
Break a crystal lake, no brekkie in bed, just chopping and hacking. My worst nightmare is to be late with same as shitting on popular fashion. Fuck popular fashion.
I'm loving the beat on this. I'm loving the whole, the instrument, the musical part of this. Lyrically, Devlin is hard to take and touch him. His stuff is always just top notch with metaphors and the way he spits, whether it be a very quick flow or just very smooth, the smoothness of his delivery and getting everything out. Talking about fuck popular fashion and really lyricism and stuff that actually makes sense or says something in the music industry really doesn't take and get any kind of it doesn't get the recognition it needs. It's all mindless bullcrap for the most part. So he's setting this up very nicely.
Fuck popular fashion, popular fashion. I don't wanna look like, sound like anyone. Write one lyric in my book like any cunt. I don't wanna replicate no one that came before me in my brain from very young.
Wow.
I don't wanna look like, sound like anyone. Write one lyric in my book like any cunt. I don't wanna replicate no one that came before me in my brain from.
Don't want to take and so he don't want to take and be simplistic. So he don't want to be simplistic. So there's somebody else before him that's better, or in front of him that's better. He wants to be at the top, but the way he took and worded that, talking about don't want to take and write one lyric, just dude, this whole thing, like his whole delivery, especially with the volume, because I don't think his vocal is as compared to the music, it's not loud, so it's very understated, but yet also very I'm liking this.
Very young, I was on my own thing. Twilight's when I zoned in. I don't wanna look like, sound like anyone. Write one lyric in my book like any cunt. I don't wanna replicate no one that came before me in my brain from very young. I was on my own thing. Twilight's when I zoned in and wrote bars and songs you'd know with a moonlight glow. When a lot of others stuck to the road thing. Think you know, Jim? You don't know shit. You ain't crawled through hell with broke limbs and got dirty like workers digging at coal pits just to be heard in the Bronx of grime. Each long.
So I love this, taking in, like I said, the first verse, basically establishing the fact that he's the best. Beginning of the second verse, he talked about you know, basically not being simplistic with this stuff. It don't want to take and be like the simple cunts. And then taking and going into the struggle, taking and climbing the ranks of the grime game. Like, this is, I'm enjoying this. In the metaphorical way that he's doing all this while also interposing, you know, straightforward lyrics with it, taking also that juxtaposition, it's done master. This dude is bar none one of the best lyricists. I don't care. Which compared to the US, you've got a lot of really talented lyricists. So got dirty like workers digging out coal pits just to be heard in the Bronx of grime, East London the dirtiest side with the feast and the vermin thrive, and you don't get nowhere so fuck popular fashion. So he actually took and fought his way up. A lot of nowadays you got a lot of these bigger time stars and stuff like that. They're basically Instagram rappers. Like, they'll take and flash stuff, but they got no substance behind it. They didn't take and work from it. Basically, they're all right. So if a little bit of a kind of a rough cut in here, my daughter tried coming in. So if you hear a noise, it's like a door cracking. That's exactly what happened. So this right here, yeah, like I said, a lot of these rappers, they put on their own Instagram and stuff like that. They show flashy stuff, but they got no substance behind them. So that they're paupers, basically. They didn't fight for anything. They haven't really had to fight, whereas somebody like Devlin and others in the game actually fought tooth and nail to take and get where they're at. So man up, woman up, be good enough, the DJ's got to put it up. Oh, wow. That's nice. And that's true. It, like, you got so much to label taking and backing these artists and stuff like that when it's garbage stuff. It's just this mindless garbage stuff. But they get pushed so much, you got to take and fight to where your stuff's good enough that it can compete, and the DJs can't take and do anything but to put it on. I like that. You don't see a whole lot of that no more. Well, you do, but it's getting harder and harder to do that. Man up, woman up, be good enough, a DJ's gotta pull it up. If it ain't your rule, then it's never good enough. Never be a fool, be cool, then it's love. When you're crying out like babies blubbering, then I'm on hand like a turtle dove. To bring a more than, and I'm a chore can, so I deservedly earn your trust. I'm no letdown, you've heard me, you've seen how I get down. COVID, I put the scene on lockdown. Meet you for the Chinese, let devs out. No cure, man, you've seen how I spread round. Bet a lot of men dream that I'm dead now. Wanna put a red beam on my head now. Self-belief, believe I'm best out. Fuck the rest now. Fuck popular fashion. Second best, no one's top, nor second, nor third, nor less. Think you're a boss, get dropped in a sec, then strive to always be the best, okay? Because, you know, second, third, basically, you're losing. Your goddamn fame and respect. You want to bet, get spun like roulette, one dart. I'm bringing the sun to an end, you can't. Question the lungs in my chest. Breathing fire, the dragon's on set. There's no need to imagine it. Feel the heat, will I lean on talentless? MC, stock and repeat. Well, let me show you what a creature of habit is. Me and I never let the level drop. Something like a head teacher, I tell him off. John's. Love that. The referencing, basically, he's spitting heat when it, you know, the dragon and stuff like that, but also the fact that, you know, he's talking about being a creature of habit, so he's always taking and practicing. He's always taking and basically, he's not going to let himself take and come down off the top of his game. I like that. Too often times you see artists take and get comfortable, and then they just, the quality of their stuff goes down. They still beat their chest, and granted, a lot of times they've taken and actually, you know, got the hits or whatever to take and, you know, have a little bit of chest beating, but they'll still proclaim to be the best when lyrically they've fallen off. So that or they're garbage and they claim to be the best, and they get more clout than others because they're backed. When, like, you see that way too much, and I think across all genres, but especially rap. You are a creature of habit, it's me and I never let the level drop. Something like a head teacher, I tell him off. John's heavy with your burn, I'm getting off. On the fact I'm the man, you can never stop. Fuck popular fashion. Fashion. I don't jump on the wagon, jump on the wagon. I like that. That's, it's very understand, as opposed to the music, because to me it sounds like his voice come in low at a lower decibel range than what the music over top of it is. I like the music over top, provided a nice juxtaposition over what he's taking and spitting, because he's taking it, it basically, it's a blueprint of what it takes to be successful, to always fight and make sure you take and put something out that they've got to take and play. They can't take and keep off their, you know, off a spin. Like, this is something right here. I just, the starting of it, taking, you know, basically declaring himself the best. And the second verse talking about the fight to take and get to where he's at, basically what he's at, you know, as far as struggling and having to claw your way up, basically, in the music industry itself. And then staying on top, always taking and bringing the heat, always taking and you know, doing what it takes, being a creature of habit, doing what it, continually doing what it takes to take and stay at the top of your game. And, you know, basically anybody tries to take and talk, you take and, he said, talking back to the, you know, to the headmaster and stuff like that. So you take and clap back, you take and tell him, you know, basically fuck off. You don't know what you're talking about. Same thing. And I think that's also a reference to probably the record labels themselves, because you got a lot of these artists that the record labels would be like, ah, nah, you're not good enough, or you're not this or not that. And it's only because they're not signed. It's not because they're not good enough or anything like that. A lot of times there's a lot of artists that are a lot better than the artists that are on the labels. And a lot of times you got to take and show them, hey, look, you want to take and shit on me, I'm going to take and shit on your artist. And so basically, that's the way you take and, you know, basically tell them to go fuck themselves. So, very good song, like this. I can't wait to hear the rest of the album. Y'all be good to each other. Love yourselves. Peace.